The majority of fresh seafood that we produce here in Louisiana goes into the restaurants. You know, so we lost initially a great deal of our crawfish business, about 80% of the crawfish, you know, and so we start looking at how it affects shrimp, how it affects everything. You know, I got a farmer that raises turtles for the export market, but the airlines wouldn't allow him to come in to ship them. And so he had them sold, but he couldn't ship them. Then we have the farmers harvesting crawfish and nowhere to go. And so right at that peak time, if you look at crawfish, you look at strawberries, you look at shrimp, look at those things that are, quote, perishable, right? We have a very defined and scheduled supply chain on all commodities. So in the first week, you know, there were issues with a shortage of, quote, toilet paper, milk, ground meat, and then what happened, as it hit all the airwaves, people began to get a little upset and concerned, and then they started buying more than they needed for the week or 2 weeks, which further exacerbated the supply chains. And we've also seen now food inflationary costs. If you look, inflationary cost of ground meat and other protein products, beef has went up about 21-22%, poultry 10%, pork 15%. You saw a huge shift up and down in eggs. You know, eggs went, you know, if you go back a year, from $1 a dozen to $3.62, now they've come back down significantly. So the availability of products, the concern at home of people being able to get those products, then what happened is that we had workers in our processing facilities get sick. And so then you have a back up all the way back. So when you think about going down to the grocery store and getting a boneless breast of chicken, right? You gotta remember, it starts off from a rooster and a hen, then there's eggs, then there's a hatchery, then there's biddies, then they have to grow out the broilers. The broilers have to then be processed, and then it's gotta be further processed until you get to that boneless breast of chicken, which has to be delivered, and all on a very, very, very tight timeline. So the stress to our farmers, you know, if you look at our crawfish farmers, they lost their crop. If you look at a lot of our farmers that raise vegetables, I've talked to our vegetable producers, without the restaurants that buy a specific type of product, a lot of that they either donated or they could not harvest. And so you have some tremendous financial considerations. Now, we've been working with the federal government under the CARES Act and what's called CFAP, and that's the Coronavirus Food Assistance Program for Agriculture, $16 billion. But we're still working to get funds for aquaculture. I spoke again at length with Secretary Baddoo about needing money specifically for farm-raised aquaculture. And so we are working on that. But the stress, you know, is people that are just concerned about the unknown. If you watch the markets are all over the place. And so with that, there's a lot of people that are under a lot of stress, but we are getting through this. Now where we are going, we are moving forward. You see the markets responding. We have a tremendous crop in the ground. The farmer is the eternal optimist, right? But they're under tremendous, tremendous amount of pressure because agriculture is big business. I've been working with our bankers because our bankers have to continue to loan money to the farmers, and the farmers have to be able to borrow that money, and we've got to get assistance so that they can have sufficient cash flow to keep all of this going. And so when you look at overall in our economy, agriculture in this state's over $13 billion. The average farmer borrows more than $1 million every year. The average farmer borrows, again, more than $1 million every year. And what happens when you have a bad year, you know, you can work with your bankers and they can help to defer some of that, but you got to have a good year coming. And so they're very concerned about where we are headed next. Because farmers are used to stress. I mean, who else in the world plants their seeds in the ground, looks up and prays to heaven and says, please rain, but not too much, right? Send out the sun, but not too much. We need a lot of fresh air, but not too much. We need a bountiful harvest. And so each and every day, right, we deal with the pressures and the stress and the breakdowns of equipment and all these different things and watching the markets. But at the end of the day, the farmers are the salt of the earth. Reach out to someone, because we're all in this together. We are getting through this together. Things are getting better together. One of the things we've learned as farmers, and they've taught us this a long, long time, if you're having a rough time, call your neighbor, call your friend, call your buddy, because it's by working together that we can get through this. My dear friends, please reach out and stay well.